They said it couldn't be done, but I did it. Chad Michael Michaels coming to you live again here on the Green Bay campus. It is hot out, but the sun isn't the only thing that's scorching. I have some crispy stories baking in the oven at 350 coming right now here on Exclusive Reporting. Thanks, Chad. I'm gonna go undercover to see what actually happens on the Green Bay campus. To keep my cover, I'm using the latest spy technology known as an office plant.
I would have done my hair.
They can't look at me in disguise.
I can see that he's there.
No, I can't.
Thanks, Chad. We've been scouring the Green Bay campus trying to find the wild Northwestern Ron. Now, wild Rons typically can be found scampering about in various places around campgrounds, but we have not been able to find one since 2020. Earlier this year, I saw a Ron, but I haven't in a while. We're gonna go try to find one. Over here, you'll see the Northwestern Ron in his natural habitat. Now, Rons can be very fast when driving carts, as he's leaving right now. Ron tends to be a very tame creature, but incredibly, incredibly able to repair anything that you might have. There he goes, look. See, he has his mate with him. Now, Rons mate for life, 10 times out of 10, and they nail it. Way to go, Ron. Thanks, Chad. Green Bay sports fans will be thrilled to know that Green Bay is putting in a bid for the World Baseball Classic. It's gonna be a home run of an event. Oh, right. Green Bay, we got rid of the backstop 6 years ago. New plan. Green Bay is gonna put in a bid for the FIFA World Cup. The goalposts are being replaced. No matter, there will be new ones, but in the meantime, no news on how this will affect Green Bay's FIFA World Cup bid. Back to you, Chad. Thanks, Chad. 4 weeks ago, Green Bay launched into a science and social experiment to see how high the grass could grow in one portion of the field. It's called the Green Bay Soul Patch. Get it? Because it's soul and patch of grass? I don't get it either. Anywho, this experiment started off as a noble quest, but has since turned into a place where I just come to watch geese frolic around in the field. Thanks, Chad. I'm here with Green Bay resident and ceramics expert, Miss Irma. We're gonna analyze this beautiful classic piece of
horrified. Hey friends, and welcome again to our virtual fireside. As some of you may notice, we're not in our usual location. That's because the waves down at our fireside are pretty epic today. So we figured, why not hang out here? We're so excited you're joining us. Thanks for welcoming us into your living rooms. We're so glad we get to do this together tonight. Now, as we get ready to jump in, we want you to find some space, grab a partner, and get your wiggle on, because we're about to do some Gorilla Wars.
Hey guys, you guys know what time it is. It is time for some Gorilla Wars. Now guys, this is our first ever multi-site Gorilla Wars battle. It's gonna be best 2 out of 3. The person that wins 2 rounds wins the entire thing for their specific group. Okay, if you guys haven't done Gorilla Wars before, it's really simple. Gorilla beats the man beats the gun beats gorilla, and if you tie, you die. And don't forget to wiggle. So you're gonna go back to back and you're gonna wiggle. And when I start going, you just do this, okay? Here we go. Okay, good, yeah. Awesome, okay, here we go. Gorilla beats the man.
Gorilla beats the man.
Man beats the gun.
Man beats the gun.
Gun beats gorilla.
Gun beats gorilla.
If you tie, you die.
If you tie, you die.
Get it? 3, 2, 1. Whoa, nice job, guys. Okay, nice round one, everyone. Nice round one. Here we go. Time for round two. Don't forget to wiggle. Gorilla beats the man.
Gorilla beats the man.
Man beats the gun.
Man beats the gun.
Gun beats gorilla.
Gun beats gorilla.
If you tie, you die.
If you tie, you die.
Get it? 3, 2, 1.
Oh,
I think I saw some ties in there. Okay, I don't know. Okay, round three. Here we go. Okay, don't forget to wiggle. Here we go. Gorilla beats the man.
Gorilla beats the man.
Man beats the gun.
Man beats the gun.
Gun beats gorilla.
Gun beats gorilla.
If you tie, you die.
If you tie, you die.
Get it? 3, 2, 1. Oh, nice job, everyone. Hey, nice job, winners. Nice job, winners. Nice job, guys. Guys, thanks for playing Gorilla Wars with us. We're gonna get into some silly songs. We have some special guests that are gonna help us with that today. Guys, take it away.
Welcome to the backyard. I am here with my brother,
Levi,
and my friend,
JM,
and myself, Noah. Today we're gonna be singing a couple funny songs together and hope you'll enjoy them. We're gonna start with Herman the Worm.
Yes.
And it is a repeat after me song. So get those loud voices ready. All right.
I'm ready.
This is a repeat after me song.
This is a repeat after me song.
Sit on my fence post chewing my bubble gum.
Sit on my fence post chewing my bubble gum.
Pop my gum like woo, woo.
Pop my gum like woo, woo.
Then along came Herman the Worm.
Then along came Herman the Worm.
And he was like this little. And I said, Herman, how'd you get so big, brother?
And I said, Herman, how'd you get so big, brother?
He said, I ate 14 pencils.
He said, I ate 14 pencils.
Sit on my fence post, chew my bubble gum.
Sit on my fence post, chew my bubble gum.
Pop my gum like, woo. Woo!
Pop my gum like woo! Woo!
Then along came Herman the Worm.
Then along came Herman the Worm.
And he was like this big. And I said, Herman, how'd you get so big, brother?
And I said, Herman, how'd you get so big, brother?
He said, I ate 14 jars of peanuts.
He said, I ate 14 jars of peanuts.
Sit on my fence post, chew my bubble gum. Pop my gum like, woo! Then along came Herman the Worm. And he was like, this big! And I said, Herman, how'd you get so big, brother?
And I said, Herman, how'd you get so big, brother?
He said, I ate 1,000,000.1 Titanics.
He said, I ate 1,000,000.1 Titanics.
Sit on my face, first chair, my bubblegum!
He said,
post, chewing my bubble gum.
Sitting on my fence post, chewing my bubble gum.
Pop my gum like woo. Woo!
Pop my gum like woo, woo!
Then along came Herman the worm.
Then along came Herman the worm.
And he was like this little.
He was like this little.
And I said, Herman, what on the planet of heaven happened?
I said, Herman, what on the planet of heaven happened?
He said, I burped.
He said, I burped. Let's go.
Woo! Yeah.
Hey guys, I'm JM.
I'm Paxton.
I'm Willa.
I'm Sloan.
And we're going to do a quick song for you guys. Are you guys ready?
Yeah!
Okay, here we go. Get down, get funky, get loose. And move to the beat. Put your whole body in it. And starts with your feet. Your feet, two, three, four. Get down, get funky, get loose. And move to the beat. Put your whole body in it. And it starts with your feet, right? Your feet, two, three, four. Your knees, two, three, four. Get down, get funky, get loose. And move to the beat. Put your whole body in it. And it starts with your feet. Your feet, two, three, four. Your knees, two, three, four. Your hips, two, three, four. Get down, get funky, get loose. And move to the beat. Uh-huh. Put your whole body in it. And it starts with your feet. Your feet, two, three, four. Your knees, two, three, four. Your hips, two, three, four. Your bum, two, three, four. Get down, get funky, get loose. And move to the beat. Put your whole body in it. And it starts with your feet. Your feet, two, three, four. Your knees, two, three, four. Your hips, two, three, four. Your bum, two, three, four. Your shoulders, two, three, four. Get down, get funky, get loose. And move to the beat. Put your whole body in it. And it starts with your feet. Your feet, two, three, four. Your knees, two, three, four. Your hips, two, three, four. Your bum, two, three, four. Your shoulders, two, three, four. Your arms, two, three, four.
Get down, get funky, get loose.
And move to the beat. Put your whole body in it. It starts with your feet. Your feet, two, three, four. Your knees, two, three, four. Your hips, two, three, four. Your bum, two, three, four. Your shoulders, two, three, four. Your arms, two, three, four. Your head, two, three, four.
Get down, get funky, get loose.
And move to the beat. Put your whole body in it. Starts with your feet. Your feet, two, three, four. Your knees, two, three, four. Your hips, two, three, four. Your bum, two, three, four. Shoulders, two, three, four. Arms, two, three, four. Your head, two, three, four. Your tongue, two, three. Get down, get funky, get loose. And move to the beat. Your whole body in it. And starts with your feet. Your feet, two, three, four. Your knees, two, three, four. Hip, two, three. So your bum, two, three. So your shoulders, two, three, four. Arms, two, three, four. Your head, two, three, four. Your tongue, two, three, four.
You're done!
Woo! Guys.
Yes!
We love doing silly songs with you guys. You guys did an awesome job moving and grooving and getting down and funky and loose. Next, we want to take some time to sing a worship song with you guys together. So this is Amazing Grace.
The power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole. We'll be right back. king who conquered the grave. Worthy is the lamb who was slain. Worthy is the king who conquered the grave. Worthy is the lamb who was slain. Worthy is the king who conquered the grave.
Today's Bible story comes from a book in the New Testament called Luke. It's a story called the Good Samaritan. It's actually referred to as a parable, and parable simply means a story that Jesus told to explain a value, a moral, a character trait, or a lesson that he wanted to teach the people. Our story tonight starts like this. On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up to test Jesus. "Teacher," he asked, "what must I do to inherit eternal life?" "Well, what is written in the law?" Jesus replied. "How do you read it?" The man responded with, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself." Jesus said, "You've answered correctly. Do this and you will live." But the man wanted to test Jesus. So he asked him, "And who is my neighbor?" And this is the story that Jesus told him.
There once was a Jewish man walking along a road. He was coming from Jerusalem and was heading to Jericho, which was a full day or two of walking. The road was rocky and there were small hills all around. The man was just walking and enjoying the nice day when suddenly a group of men jumped out from behind a hill. They took all his belongings and tore off most of his clothes. They didn't want him to follow them, so they beat him up very badly and left him lying and bleeding on the side of the road. A few minutes later, a priest was walking down the same path and noticed the man lying on the side of the road. Do you know what he did? You'd think he'd run over and help the man, right? Well, instead, he crossed the road and walked on the other side and acted like he didn't see the man. About an hour or so later, another man, called a Levite, was walking down the road. Levites were people who assisted priests with their work. He'd probably help the man, right? But you know what he did? He slowed down, walked a little closer to the man, but then kept walking without helping him at all. You might be thinking the man lying by the road looked like he was resting and that this is why the priest and the Levite didn't stop to help. The trouble is, it was easy to tell he was badly hurt. The man was bleeding, had most of his clothes ripped off him, and he was bruised and hardly breathing. Just a few minutes later, another man came walking. He was a Samaritan. There's one thing you should know about Samaritans. Jews didn't like them. Jews usually didn't treat Samaritans very well, so they never got along. The man who was dying on the road was a Jew. So what do you think the Samaritan did? As soon as the man saw him, he went over to him and felt compassion for him. He put bandages on his sores and poured oil and wine, which were really expensive back then, on the man's sores to prevent them from getting worse. Then he lifted the man on his own donkey and took him to a hotel to take care of him. The next day, the Samaritan took out enough money so the man could stay at the hotel until he was well enough to leave. He paid the man at the front desk and asked him to take care of the man. If he wasn't better after a little bit of time, the Samaritan would come back and pay for any extra costs. Of the three people who crossed the man on the road that day, the Samaritan, the most unlikely of all three, was the one who showed compassion, love, and kindness to someone in need.
When Jesus finished telling the man the story, he said this, Which of these three do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers? The man responded with, the one who had mercy on him. Jesus told him, go and do likewise. Here's the thing about the story of the Good Samaritan. It's a story that asks the question, who is our neighbor? The answer that Jesus gives, anyone and everyone. Oftentimes we think that our neighbor is the person who lives to our left and to our right. But our neighbor is actually anyone that we come in contact with. It's our friends at school, it's our friends down the street, it's our teachers, the grocery store clerk, or anyone that we pass on the sidewalk. Our neighbors are all around us. And what Jesus asks us to do is to love them extravagantly, to serve them well, and to have compassion, which means to care for them in any and every way possible. The story of the Good Samaritan is one that encourages us and challenges us to love like Jesus did, with no limits, no restraints, and no questions. This week, who might be someone that you may not have before considered your neighbor, but now understand is your neighbor, that you need to go love, serve, and care for? Can you name them? Can you write them a note? Can you send them a video saying that you love them and that you're thinking about them? Can you ride your bike past their street and wave as they stand out front? Can you bake them cookies? What can you do this week to love someone around you in a beautiful, extravagant, super big way? That's our challenge for you. Guys, let's pray together about how God might encourage us to find the people that we can love extravagantly. God, we love you and we love the way that you love. We want to love more like you. So would you help us have eyes to see people around us this week that we can love and care for and serve generously and extravagantly? God, we want to be just like you. And we want this world to know what your love looks like, feels like, and sounds like. Amen.
Hey, Green Bee families, thank you so much for joining us again for another virtual fireside. And thank you to the amazing creative team that puts these together for us each week. How much fun is it to watch and experience all of these stories together, all the fun news updates, and all the creativity of the families that have joined us this time. So thank you to all of you that joined us this week. Moving ahead this summer is very different for us. We still have the opportunity to have up to 50 people on our campus. And starting on July 6th, we have the deep privilege of continuing to minister to families by being a place where they can come, restore, reconnect, and relax all together in a campground version. And we can hardly wait until people step onto this campus where we can continue to love and serve those that join us. So pray for us as we move forward in this summer, as we seek to love our neighbors, love one another, and help people experience the love and joy of Christ. And so in the days ahead, we can hardly wait if you're joining us. For those of you that can't join us this summer, please know that we are anticipating 2021 like no other. We're planning, we're praying, and we are so excited for the days ahead. So please stay tuned for the things that are coming in the future for Green Bay Bible Camp. The reason why I'm standing right here right now is because if you look behind me, we have a brand new dock that has been officially completed, and it is waiting for you to come and blob and jump and swim and enjoy time together. So anticipate the days ahead with us. We are praying for you. We are so excited. We're trusting the Father and seeking to love our neighbors that all come here this summer.
Guys, thank you so much for coming to hang out with us again at Fireside. We love being able to do this with you guys. We love it more than when Herman the Worm was as big as he possibly could get before he was this little again.
Guys, we think it's so great that we get to come hang out with you guys in your living rooms to get silly, to get down, get funky, get loose, to sing worship songs, and to hear more stories from the Bible together. We love this time and we value it so much. We're gonna keep doing these things together over the course of the summer, so make sure that you stay connected so that we can continue having a lot of fun together.
Mm-hmm. Guys, thank you so much to Sloan, Paxton, and Willa for joining us, and
to Noah and to Levi, to Gingy, Ronan, Isla, and Abby. We are so thankful for you guys hanging out with us today.
Mm-hmm. Guys, thank you so much for continuing to engage with us. We love seeing your messages, comments, DMs, all that stuff.
You guys are awesome. We're sending you lots of love today, and we'll see you next time. Bye, friends.
See you guys.